The third annual Sweep South report on pay and working conditions for domestic work in South Africa was released, and it paints a stark picture of the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on the lives of women striving to make a living as domestic workers in South Africa. We have a chat to Luke Kannemeyer, Head of Growth and Strategy at Sweep South. You're listening to our social newscast with me, Sam Marshall, brought to you by www.social-tv.co.za. Thank you very much for your time. Just talk to us about the third annual Sweep South report on pay and working conditions for domestic workers, because it does paint a dire picture of the current situation.
Yeah, so we compiled our third annual report on domestic work pay and conditions. We're not necessarily intending to focus on the COVID-19 pandemic initially. We definitely knew that our data would paint a picture of what was happening at the moment. But certainly once we started to get our preliminary data, we started to notice a far dire picture emerge. So essentially what this report is aimed at doing is it's part of Sweep South's mission, who's the leading platform across Africa for to book domestic services online. And essentially part of our mission is not just to see the improvement on conditions for our workers, it's to see the improvement of conditions across the sector for domestic workers. And so we wanted to shine a light on how things were progressing year on year. So we chose certain benchmarks such as pay, costs, living expenses, treatment by clients, and we wanted to measure those year on year. And essentially this year is that no one expected what would happen this year. And what we saw emerging in our data was something that we felt we had to go even deeper and further. And this is where we compiled the COVID-19 edition of the report and found that there were severe consequences on domestic workers. So we saw that essentially expenses had increased significantly. So expenses were up nearly 35%, which far outstrips inflation. And this is largely as a result of the increased number of our domestic workers who are now the main breadwinners in their homes. So because the economy at large has lost many jobs or many people are not earning, now the domestic workers who were earning or who were able to receive other forms of income during this period were now responsible for their homes as the main breadwinner, even though this was generally the case before. This was to a far greater degree this year. We also saw the number of dependents, so the number of people they were supporting increase, responsible for meals that they wouldn't ordinarily have to be responsible for. What people may not recognize is South Africa actually has one of the best food, the school's feeding schemes in the world, which does ensure that learners receive meals during the day at school. Parents, or essentially the breadwinners, now had to provide for those meals. And so this increase in expenses was then against the backdrop of a massive decrease in earnings, where the monthly minimum wage for domestic workers is generally in excess of 2,600 Rand. We saw that at least the bulk of workers prior to this period, so 63%, were earning above that. And with the onset of lockdown, 75% of domestic workers then fall below that threshold. And so what you had here was a massive discrepancy in expenses and earnings. Yeah. And this meant that spending had to be reduced in certain places. And this is where we uncovered the most concerning finding, which was essentially that we saw that domestic workers were cutting down on food expenses. And now they had more mouths to feed and they had to feed them more frequently, but were now pulling back on how much they were spending on food. And this meant opting for less nutritious options, opting for smaller portions. And while you and I as adults would be able to go 6 months with the reduced intake of food, we would emerge, should we return to normal levels, okay after that period. But what we see in children, if they face a period of shortage of nutrients or poor nutrients, that malnutrition could have consequences for the rest of their lives. Yeah. And so COVID-19 is not going to be over, possibly for a whole generation. And yeah, that's where we see urgent intervention being needed.
Just from these findings, It then also speaks to a larger problem that if these domestics have seen a massive reduction in their incomes and their salaries, they are directly tied to households, then it also speaks to how their households have been negatively affected by the COVID impact.
So what we notice with the point you've made about that, we see that possibly this is indicative of their households being affected, is that essentially what our reports have shown is that pay in the domestic work sector in South Africa has been largely stagnant for the past 3 years. And this has been due to the severe pressure on the middle class in South Africa, of where they have had to cut spending due to slow economic growth, slow wage growth, and increasing expenses.
The other added effect of having somebody who's now earned a certain amount and has the added stresses, as you were eloquently stated earlier, having more mouths to feed, who is in an extreme situation, is that it could potentially then trigger mental issues.
And that's certainly the case that we saw. So this is often an issue that we see downplayed amongst poor people, especially poor Black people, that we don't recognize the effects of depression, anxiety, other mental health issues. And so that's also something there where we see urgent intervention. And we know that in the public health service in South Africa, that only about 1 in 10 people are able to get the mental health treatment that they require. And we saw over 50% of the workers we surveyed reporting that their mental health has been affected during the lockdown.
We know the government has worked on improving the lives of domestics by putting some laws in place. Surely it'd been very difficult to manage and police during this lockdown period. And I'm not sure how far and wide your survey went in terms of finding whether domestics were exploited during this period.
So we did look at the general treatment of how domestic workers perceive the treatment of their clients in terms of abusive language or behavior towards them. And in essence there, we saw that that was not a very reported to a very large proportion amongst the workforce. What we did see is that where government intervention was successful is that up to 75% of South Africans did receive some support from government during the period. But when it comes to actual enforcement of legislation, we can see in our data, although there weren't necessarily specific questions in this survey about it, but in terms of our observations of the industry, that this is where government actually has very little ability currently to enforce the conditions which they have tried to put in place around regulating domestic work. But we have seen things such as when we looked at the expenses, that data and airtime had shown a decrease in expense this year. And that we believe was due to government intervention in that industry. And so we definitely see that there's a big role of government to play here in being able to improve the lives of domestic workers. And obviously with working with bigger players like the telcos, they can do that from one perspective. But another perspective we saw, and we see the Competition Commission is looking into it, is price gouging around food that we also saw that workers reported. But unfortunately, when it comes to ensuring that client treatment and client pay is sustained and they're adhering to regulations during this time, we haven't seen any specific initiatives there. But we didn't see that emerge in the sort of qualitative data that we extracted from workers. But this is more likely due to a lack of knowledge of what their rights are in these situations.
Final question. I want to touch on your fund, the Sweepstar fund that you guys created. Just quickly talk to me about some of the interventions that you've seen. How have South Africans rallied around it? And what have you guys managed to raise thus far in the fund to be able to contribute to the plight of the domestic worker in South Africa?
So every worker on our platform, so every worker who had signed up to Sweep South to be able to access clients and domestic work, were active in the month preceding lockdown. We have managed to raise the Sweepstar fund. So that was both from our investors and other corporate sponsors. So we have a number of social impact investors, and through them we were able to raise a substantial portion of eventually 13 million rand. So this was contributed both from our employees as well, us as a company, and from our clients. But we did see that most clients were more interested in contributing to their individual domestic worker directly. And so this is their individual Sweepstar, which is what we call the workers on our platform. So even though we've managed to raise $13 million as a general pool to support all workers who were active in that month preceding, we were able to also then enable mechanisms of clients to contribute directly. And so we raised 13 million rand. And as the sweep stars have returned to work this year, is that as their earnings started to increase, we started to taper the funds available. But to date, there even are those who are still unable to return to work, either through being high risk or where we can see that demand has not returned in certain areas. And so sweep stars continue to receive support from that fund if they're not earning above certain thresholds during this period.